C scale, the C major scale that I was playing around with, and I'm going to show you that one today. The major scale is kind of like the DNA of music. Most music theory terms are explained using the major scale, so they're important to know, important to know about, and also important to have under your fingers. So let me just run through the scale from low to high, back to low, one octave, so eight notes, and then I'll show you some ways that you can use this scale. So here's the scale from C to C. So this is concert B flat, which is the trumpet C. So if you play this on a piano, you're going to hear it start on the B flat, one of the black keys. But for trumpet music, it's a C, the first ledger line below the staff. Okay, pretty simple. Now, within that one scale, there are a whole bunch of other scales. They're called modes. And the modes, in fact, the major scale is one of the modes. It's called the Aeolian mode. The modes are useful because if you use that one scale, if you have the C major scale down, you then also have seven other scales. All you have to do is start on a different starting note. So just then, the major scale, we started on C. If I start on D and use the same pattern, no sharps and no flats, so I'm doing an octave from D to D. This is called the Dorian mode, or the Dorian scale. And you'll find this a lot in improvising. It's the two chord, if that means anything to you. And it sounds like this. It's got kind of a minor feel to it. So then you can just keep doing that up the scale. So the next one, if we start on E to E, that's the Phrygian mode. Got kind of a nice sound. The next one, we start F to F. G to G is the Mixolydian. That's another important one. The 2, the Dorian, and the 5, the Mixolydian, are very important scales in improvising and just in basic music harmony. So the Mixolydian starts on G, G to G. Now, if you find that that one is too high for you, it's too difficult, you can play the lower octave too, and that would be from G to G, an octave lower. It looks like this. Okay, it's way down there. The next one is the Aeolian mode. It's also known as the natural minor scale. It's another very useful scale, and that goes from A to A. And again, you can either do this, the high version, which I'm going to play for you first, or the lower version, if that first version is too high for you. Again, this is also known as the minor scale, the natural minor scale. The natural minor scale, same exact notes, starting on a different place than the major scale. It's also known as the relative minor. So C major, the relative minor for C major is A minor. There are six notes between them. So you go C, D, E, F, G, A, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's the sixth degree of the major scale. You can find the natural minor scale. The last one is Locrian, from B to B. Okay, so those are all the modes in C major. Again, there's C, Aeolian, which is C major, C to C, D, Dorian, E, Phrygian, F, Lydian, G, Mixolydian, A, Aeolian, and B, Locrian. Now, there's a particular pattern of half steps and whole steps when you use those scales. It's not all that important to know it when you play it, but when you practice your major scale, practice all those modes as well. There are also a couple scales that you'll find useful within each of these major scales. One of them, we'll do two pentatonic scales. The major pentatonic, if we count the scale degrees like I did earlier, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, or 1 again, the major pentatonic uses 1, 2, 3, 5, and 6. Okay, and it's called a pentatonic scale because there's five notes in it, penta, right? So it sounds like this. Now, that first time up, I didn't kick my D, my trigger, and that note was out of tune. So make sure that you get in the habit of kicking that trigger for the low D, 1 and 3. So that was the major pentatonic. The good news is that the same notes in that major scale can be used for the minor pentatonic. Now, just like with the natural minor scale, we're going to start on the sixth degree, and it uses the exact same notes as that pentatonic that I just gave you, but they're in a different order. So this time we start on the C and use the same notes. I'm sorry, we start on the A and use the same notes. So it's going to go A, C, D, E, G, and back down. Sounds like this. One last scale that's related to this key that you'll probably find useful is the blues scale. And the blues is kind of a minor sounding scale, and it also starts on that low A. And the difference, there's a couple notes difference, I'll just play it and you can hear it. Okay, so within that one scale, that C major scale, you have all kinds of different scales to practice. Now, of course, you can practice them just going up and down, which is, of course, useful. There's all kinds of patterns that you can do with these scales. You can do thirds. And, of course, you can vary, and you should vary, the rhythm, the tone quality, the dynamics, all of these other things to make these more interesting, to get them under your fingers in more ways. So, for example, if I took this pattern of thirds and did it in triplets, okay, so three notes per beat, it would sound like this. All right. There's another pattern called rolling thirds. You can find it in the Clark studies. And that looks like this. And of course, you can vary the tonguing, you can vary all kinds of things with these scales. So I highly recommend that you practice them, have fun. And one of the most fun ways to practice these, in my opinion, is once you have those down, is to just improvise over the scale like I did at the beginning of this little video. That's a lot of fun. It gets the scale under your finger. You don't have to worry about patterns and right or wrong and just have fun with it. So there's the C major scale. Stay tuned for all the others.